These are the plates that I've chosen for the first cell that I'll be building. They're test plates. They're the first. They most certainly won't be the last. What I've done here is I've bolted them together tightly so that when I drill my center hole to mount them together with my non-conductive mounting material, they'll be evenly spaced as far as the ends. This is going to be important because I'm going to try two designs first. And primarily I want to focus on John Aaron's work with the Widowmaker that he has designed, in that the spacing between the plates is varied. I've studied the pictures that he sent to me on the computer there by email. I've studied them very closely. I want to mimic that as closely as possible by use of washers, non-conductive washers at that. Also, what you'll notice, which is a little different with my design, is that I'm not going to cut out a corner piece of the plates and then rotate them and connect electrodes, the anode and diode, I believe it is, the way they're referred. I'm not going to connect them like that. I'm going to do something a little different. After these are connected in the center, I'm going to drill out one end. I'm going to make it a little larger and then stagger them. And I'll have my electrodes coming through in the center here. And at first, I'm going to lay the plates on their side, not straight up and down, but on their side, like this, connecting the anode and diode, or the positive and negative of my direct current, my 12-volt battery from the car or the truck, whichever's handy at that particular moment. And I'll have the testing proceed at that point with the anode and diode just a little bit differently placed. I don't think, nor do I know, that that's going to give me any better hydrogen production. I just happen to think about these particular plates that I saw at Home Depot the other day, and they're stainless steel. They're plates that you mount on the wall. My intention, when I space these and start varying the degrees of their angles with in relation to one another, they curve down on the ends, and the best way for me to work these right now is to work with the center connection, the side connections here being the anode and the diode, and allowing the ends that curve here to come in as close proximity to the other plates as possible, so that the most efficient hydrolysis, or electrolysis I should say, occurs. So that's where we're at right now, and I'm going to drill these out now, and we'll see what it looks like then.